Subhanallah.
Even if they are throwing their pebbles against Shaitan, they are still being selfish. People deceive themselves. You come down to from this state from Nigeria with that huge amount of money. Or Senegal. Or Ghana. Or you come from any country. And you are doing Torah, that you are not even sure that Allah is going to accept it. And you are now being selfish. They will not say, oh, Emma will be, this is me. Some will even be and say, I just complete this Torah. Now, I want to go and take Zemzem water. Are you going to drink? We cannot drink. What are we doing? It's only Salat. Even if you are mad, you cannot even do selfie. Are we telling lies? You can't do selfie well on Salat. Even when you are having fast, when you are taking your sahur, if you want to break your mind, you can do selfie. But on Salat,
my
promise is that that is the last that gives your hand in our religion. And that is that no matter how mad somebody is, he may be smoking hand. He will tell you that I don't play my 5-minute prayer. I don't play with it, I don't joke with it. Go to Ireland, you will know me very well. Even the chief imam knows me very well. The ladan also knows him very well. He said, I don't joke with my Salat. I may be doing people to mysterious things, but it's not enough. The Prophet must understand this. On that one, the first judgment, the first accountability that we are going to give before Allah is on Salat. That if your Salat is not okay, your heart has no meaning. Even if they don't go into the prayer side, we don't have anything to be done to the I observe
Zakat.
If your Salat is not okay, they will just push you one side. Anybody at the Salat is okay. Musa said he's among the successful ones. And if your Salat is devoid or
defective,
he's a loser and is going to be among the losing ones. He will not be among the losers on the day of judgment. There is a story in the life of the Prophet. And what is that story about? That mosque of the Prophet that we are going to visit. For those of us that have visited Medina, the Prophet was seated one day. There is a Sahaba called Khalid bin Rafia. He came into the mosque. He observed the Salat. The Prophet was watching him. When he was about leaving the mosque, he stayed asleep to the Prophet of Allah. The Prophet said, what did you just do now? He said, I observed Salat. The Prophet said, go back and repeat that Salat. He did the ruku. He said, go back and repeat that Salat. He did the ruku. He did the sajida. What did the Prophet tell him? He said, go back and observe the Salat.
Oh Lord, Father.
He went back again.
What did they father?
He came back to the Prophet.
Salaam alaikum.
He said, Salaam alaikum, Messenger of Allah. The Prophet said, what did you do?
What did
you
kill him?
He said, observe Salat. He said, go back again. You have not observed
Salat.
He did that 3 times. The man was not ashamed. He said, oh Messenger of Allah. Even if you return me by 1,000 times. I can't preach more than one.
And leave me, come over and
keep. Teach me, O Messenger of Allah, how to observe Salat.
So,
the Prophet now taught him.
Only emphasis on what because
the Prophet emphasized on some areas that are very, very important. That while on Salat,
draw
Stand firm and ensure that your mind is on that solat. While some people are standing while on solat, how do you stand? The kind of posture that you cannot even do before Buhari, you now do that posture before Allah. Some people will be observing solat. You will be looking at the whole world in the mosque. You will be watching everywhere. You'll be praying and you'll be looking everywhere. He wiped with his beard. You'll be playing with the beard. You'll be playing with the beard. While he was praying. What about the hijab? You'll now be doing hijab, you'll be looking at it.
That won't let me as if anyone.
How is his soul going to be on that solar? That even when you go to Ruku,
Ruku talk to everybody.
Ruku in such a way that your mind will be there.
And this means what Ruku is going to do.
There is a tradition, there is an authentic tradition that says that when you are good, your back must be flat. That if they put a bottle of water there, it will be faint. Some people are laughing. Bottle of water will throw away. Because of the way some people do their
business.
How are you doing your home? When you leave the ruku posture, some people from ruku they just go to the sujood. He said, go back and stand firm, and your mind will be there. You don't go from ruku to sujood. That while you're sujood, relax there. Let your mind be there. Don't be like a chicken that is taking corn.
You know, this is
one of the authentic acts of the Prophet of Allah. The worst of thief, act of theft that one can commit is the one that you commit while on solat. People are surprised. How can somebody steal while on solat? That person does not do the ruku very well. Somebody does not do the sujood very well. The Prophet said these are criminals. They are thieves. After that,
Suratul Fatiha alone.
Our Suratul Fatiha on solat. How do we recite it?
We
are meeting Allah help us. Some people, they are big scholars.
What a pen was.
They have been in the religion for a long time. But ask them to recite Suratul Fatiha. In fact, when you listen to the recitation, you have to block your hair. What you say in Uku, some people don't even know. They don't ask. I know some people
are
on Ruku. You will be the wife that are
not
that are sick. And the children that are sick. That is what they are saying there. All this you need to know there.
I want to say, you know, I get them to our room.
And this is what we need to take and put our mind on that solat.
Yeah, but I feel like that.
If you observe the solat the way it's supposed to be,
you know, it's too much fun and to like it.
The greatest reward of this life,
you will
take you away from people's hearts.
I like it when you're away. I like it when I'm happy.